Tim?
Wow, great.
We're getting a lot of good better.
You've been on vacation?
No, I just gave you more information than the sentiment of you. I also have. As mentioned in the report, we've got our second commemorative medallion out. We did the 463 last year. And this year, it was the coal tipping. What do you want to know?
Oh, no.
Well, here, if you don't come on, I'm sure I do. I know you don't have one. I want you to broke the door off. Every year we're going to do a commemorative coin like that as a fundraiser for the Friends. And like I said, last year we did the 463 because it came back into service. And this year we did the, and if anyone wants to look at it, just get one of the commissioners or John and you can look at it. But this year we did the coal tipple because it is one of the most iconic structures on our railroad, or to signify, you know, the Denver Rio Grande narrow gauge system. So we'll start to sell those and have those available, but thought I'd get it to you guys so you've got it for your collection.
Thank you.
So.
And I suppose this is for sale through the website?
Yep, we're gonna start to send out order forms and we'll have them available starting tomorrow at our dinner. We have our spring dinner starting, our dinner tomorrow night at in Albuquerque, so we'll have them on sale, and we'll have them on sale during the course of the year. So they're done up pretty nice. In fact, I think we took the image from our Dorman collection. We got a good crisp image of the coal tipple, so it's a pretty nice medallion. Let's see, our work session season is getting close at hand. I mean, we're a couple months away. We have 50 to 60 people signed up right now, and forums keep coming in daily, and people chomp at the bit to get on a project. We have our 7 weeks starting May 19th, which is the week leading up to opening day. So again, session A, B, those are in Antnedal predominantly, although we will be doing a special OB session May 5th through 9th, and that'll be in Antnedal to get the pile driver ready for the charter that John Bush had mentioned in his report. So early May, then the next two in May, then June, August, and then we finish up session G again in Antnedal September 29th through the 3rd. So we hope we have good turnout. We had about 375 people that showed up last year. I mean, when I say people, I say equivalents. You know, some person might be here for all 7 weeks, some for two, but 375 equivalents. So we hope that continues. That's a challenge we do have as an organization. 4 or 5 years ago, we were up around 500. But if you understand our demographics, we have to get more youth into our organization. You know, they're the 60s and 70 year olds, and I've been here about 10 years now, and remarkably enough. And I've been commenting, and we're gonna be talking to our directors about what are we gonna look like in 10 years from now. We're all gonna be 10 years older. Some of us won't be with us anymore. And so we're gonna have to look at what we do to continue to support the work project part of our mission, you know, helping out John with railroad projects, basic historic preservation, so we have, you know, a 40, 50 car freight fleet that we can do charters, that sort of thing. So we do have to look at that. One of the ways we are is we have this project down at Sandia High School in Albuquerque, where we've taken an idler flat, trucked it down there, Russell trucked it down from the yard here. And the guys in the wood metal automotive shop, they've taken the deck off. And just a couple weeks ago, had a load of lumber delivered. And interestingly enough, it's reclaimed lumber from one of the Hamas fighters. Mm-hmm. And so now they'll start to redeck that idler flat. And then when it's finished, obviously it will come back to the railroad to use in charters. But these guys that are working on it are so excited. And we're looking at having another media day. And I think in December when I was up, I distributed that Albuquerque Journal article. And we're going to have another media day. But those are the students, yes.
Yeah, the TV stations want to follow that.
Well, yeah, when they start making some more progress, we're going to get them back there. But it's such a good story because these guys are not the type of individuals, they're not going to go to college. They're going to learn a trade. And Dan Pizell, one of our directors, is going to bring 3-4 of them up for one of the work sessions, and we'll sponsor them coming up so they get up here. And we got one guy who's graduating, where he wants, John, I'll get you his name. He wants to come work for a river. I mean, this I'll tell you, he's fired up, and some of these guys just grabbed a hold of this. And it's neat to see. It's really neat to see. It's such a good story. Yeah. The girls that are in the photography class at Sandia, they come and take pictures to kind of chronicle the progress. So it's one of those things we want to do more of. And Sandia has indicated they would take on another car. And when we get done with this, we want to put a report together and see if we can shop this out, and no pun intended, but shop this out to potentially other high schools in New Mexico and Colorado, because it's a great way of bringing in that next generation that we need, because otherwise my fear is we'll have a membership-based organization, but we're going to run out of people to come up and do the work. Because people today, you know, you got the Bob Rosses of the world and Ted Linda Smiths and folks like that. You know, they got great pensions. They got, you know, and I'm just saying that they can come up and spend the time. But when you look at 40-year-olds that will be following us between career and families, mom might say, "You want to go up to China to do what? I want to go to Disney World with the kids," and you know, that sort of thing. So it's an issue we have to address, and one thing we're going to work on. So I say the Sandia project and what we could do here forward, I think it's very important and something that could really bode well for our mission, for the railroad, and again, like Lenore mentioned, the junior engineer program, bringing that next generation here that are going to follow in our footsteps. So we'll keep you apprised of that. But other than that, one other thing I don't have in the report I want to mention, since all the folks from Magneto here, we are diligently working on photos. Bob Ross spent yesterday with our Dorman guys finding historic Magneto photos that we want to help with the space you're going to give us to interpret the railroad. We have a fella that has come out since the December meeting, lives in Marysville, Kansas. He has a scale model of the old coal ramp platform in Antonito. And he's going to drive that out and donate it to us so we can put in the museum. And we'll have a acrylic top made so the kids can't, paw it up and that sort of thing. But he'll give us a one drop bottom dime with it, and we'll go out and buy a scale model, 463 probably, to represent what that looked like. So this guy, just out of the clear blue, not knowing what we were doing, said, "Hey, would you like this model?" And absolutely, we know right where we're going to put it. So, but anyway, so we are working on that, and when we get all that stuff put together, we need to get with you all, and you tell us where we can put it, and that sort of thing. There's some great photos there, you know.
Oops.
I'll tell you, all of you, if you'd ever get the time and want to come down to our office and look through this collection, which is all digital, there are some great photos. I know Bob was mesmerized, you know, all over the rear, but we saw some really neat ones in Antietam. And so, anyway, but that's my report. I'm gonna, if you'll give this back to
Tim?
Yes.
If that collection is all digital, why couldn't we have a screen in each depot where people could look at it?
We do have it on some of it on our web, and we could potentially look at doing something like that. Because if we put so much of it on the web, because if people look at it and say, geez, I'd like to have a nice print so I can have it framed, they can do that. And so we're seeing more of that, Randy. So we could. Because it is, it's quite an asset that, and it keeps building. I mean, it's not only the dormant collection, but more people have now contributed additional collections. So we're becoming quite a repository for the narrow gauge. So.
I mean, I think one of the problems is so big is that it's overwhelming, and so you have to be disordered.
Well, yeah, I mean, it just might be some resource we could work with, though, because. You know, the more things that we can think of that make the depots something that's fun to go to between the hours when there's no train there, you know, the better it is. It causes people to stop and spend time in the towns.
Well, and another thing, Randy, we're talking about, and we'd like to approach Stephen Flowers and John, is at Osher in the lunchroom. Well, Stephen always has, he's still got the record collection up there. But we've got so many photos that we could fill Osier Dining Hall up. And people, I would think, would be just love to look at it. You know, so anyway.
What's holding you up on that? The resource?
No, nothing. We just came up with this idea, so we need to socialize it with Stephen, John, and then do it. If you'll allow us to do it.
I had talked to Stephen before about that idea, and he loved it. He thought it would be great, didn't he? And there are a few funds available in the commission Osier account that, if it's a matter of the cost of frames or something, I'm sure we could come up with that.
Sure. Well, we appreciate you letting us work on that. And the last thing. I'll pass this around to you guys if you'll give it back. This is the Prospector, which is from the Rio Grande Modeling and Historical Society, but a good article here by Fred Morton on the 463, Mud Hen 463 rides again. So this is about the charter last May when we ran it across the rail. So.
What issue is that?
It just came out. It's.
Because I carry that in my store.
It's volume 13, number 1, first quarter of this year.
So, order some extras.
Yeah, we just got it in the office. So. Thanks. There you go. Thank you, and thank you guys for all your support.
Thanks, Tim.
Thank you, Tim.
Thanks, Tim.
Yes, sir.
Tim, my recollection, which is none too good and getting worse, is that in the past you have presented to the commission a list of projects, if you will, for each of the work sessions and in advance, and I must admit I was sort of looking forward to having that this time.
I'm working on I have to submit to SHPO, which goes to you first, and so give me a week or so here to finish it up so you have it.
That would be great. We won't have an opportunity as a commission to approve it before you start.
That would be great. Full conference?
Well, it would have to be an official meeting. It would have to be a special meeting. We could do that, but I think we need to figure that in and not just let it slide.
No. I'll make sure I get that together. Give me another week, 10 days.
A secondary question is tied to that one. Do you guys have a sort of a strategic plan? I mean, we're now, that's a buzzword with us because we've been working so hard for the last several months to get a plan put together for the commission and obviously the railroad. Do you have such a plan so we could sort of commingle, if you will? And
I can get it to you. It was a plan that Bob Ross was part of the development team who put together back around 2008 or so, I think.
That time.
And I can send it to you.
Are you still in practice?
We try not to
Ryan updated, and maybe not as religious as we should be, but we do. I can get that to you. And then along with the projects as well, so.
But then I think we will have to, Mr. Chairman, have a, an announced phone meeting to approve it.
Okay, and I'll get with you.
Thanks.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Jason, Jeremy.
Just like to remind everybody of our experience in front of the LFC this year before the session started. One of the members asked us if there was any educational component to the Coombers and Toltec, and we were able to share the experience of the car being down at Sandia High School, and they were hugely impressed by that. And I think taking that information to Colorado also would probably be very beneficial. Just as another selling point that you want to actually develop in the generation.
Great. Thanks, Tim. Public input?